guys, I'm Tanya and I'm a travel vlogger and today I'm in Shillong, the Scotland of the East. So today's plan is that I'm just going to be going around the city and taking you guys with me to all the places around Shillong. So we'll probably be doing a lot of touristy things. But two things before we start off. I'm staying at this wonderful property called JKR Residency and it was kind of a lucky find for me because I think it's really well located and also a very good place to stay at. And secondly, if you want to get around Shillong, there are various ways of getting around. You can take a shared cab, you can take a private cab, and also probably a bus to various places. But one thing that nobody else will tell you is that you can also get a bike rental here. So you can either rent out a scooty or a motorbike, which you can use to go around various places. And I think that's very cheap and very convenient way of getting around to places. But most people in Shillong probably don't know that you can actually get a bike rental even here. So if you just go through your basic Google research for bike rentals, you'll find various options for renting out a bike here. And that is what I did this morning. And I'm going to be taking you around today on a bike. Let's go. So I just rented out myself a bike for the day, a scooter from Dapli Bike Rentals. It was quite close to where I'm living right now. And Christopher, who I just met right now, is helping me shape my itinerary for the day of all the places that I can visit and in what order should I visit them. So kids, this is how you form your itinerary. This is how you talk to people and get recommendations from locals. In case you're looking for bike rentals in Shillong, this is the place where I rented it out from, so you can definitely come and check it out. So the cost of renting a bike here is 700 per day if you're renting it out for 24 hours. If you're renting it out for 10 hours, it will be approximately rupees 500. The tour of Shillong begins right now and I absolutely love having a scooty on me because it makes me feel so independent and I can cover so many places in record time, which I think as opposed to having a taxi on you is so much more convenient. The first place that I'm here at is called Cathedral Church. It's a 20th century church and I think it's a massive blue structure. If you're in Shillong, you cannot miss it if you're walking down the streets. Yesterday I was shooting a food video and I was walking down the streets and I noticed the structure and I knew that I just had to be here. So this church is called the Cathedral of Mary Help of Christians and on the inside it's a really beautiful church. It has some high ceilings, some arches, stained glass windows, and overall it's a very beautiful church on the inside, but unfortunately videography is not allowed inside. So you guys will have to come to Shillong and see it for yourself. In Shillong. This is quite a tourist destination. In fact, at the entry itself, you'll see people selling cotton candy, balloons. The entry fee here is 5 rupees and also if you have a camera like me, you'll have to declare your camera and buy a 20 rupee extra fee for it. Also, apparently, if you live in Shillong, I am so jealous of this fact that you can actually pay a jogger's fee and come to this park every day to jog. Plus, it's so scenic and the weather is so nice in Shillong. Oh my goodness, people in Shillong, you're so lucky. So this is all Watts Lake that you see behind me. It has a really nice path that runs along the lake, so perfect for walkers, joggers, strollers, kids who want to play in the grass, or it's just basically a very good natural retreat. Welcome to Golf Course! अच्छा अगर शिलोंग में आके असली स्कॉटलैंड ऑफ द ईस्ट देखना है एंड इफ़ यू वांट टू एंजॉय द ग्रीनरी आउट हियर आई थिंक दिस हैज़ टू बी द मोस्ट परफेक्ट प्लेस बिकॉज व्हाट दिस प्लेस इज सो प्रिटी. यहाँ पे देयर इज लेयर्स आफ्टर लेयर ऑफ ग्रीन एक्सपैंस ऑफ लैंड प्लस माउंटेन्स इन द बैकग्राउंड. ऑल्सो ओवर हियर देयर आर सम किड्स हु आर प्लेइंग फुटबॉल. So kind of has a really nice energy and also the place is beautiful.
Hi!
Hi Max!
Yes.
Wow!
Hey, what's
kiss?
Kiss?
destination for today, at least for tonight, is Police Bazaar, and I'm inside a place called Tibetan Market. It's almost closing time, as you can see. Most of the shops are already closing down, but this place has a lot of really nice clothes, so you can come here for shopping. I just got myself a pair of jeans from here because my jeans got dirty while I was shooting at Bodge Lake. So this is the state of my jeans right now, and unfortunately, because I was traveling light, I was only carrying one pair of jeans. Good morning, guys. It's another perfect day here in Shillong, and the weather is absolutely perfect and gorgeous. It's about 16-17 degrees probably, which is why I'm wearing a jacket again. I'm thinking of leaving for a place called Letnam near Shillong. So it's about 20-30 minutes from where I'm staying right now, and it should be a very pleasant drive. Of course, it's gonna be on the colder side too, because it's gonna get windy while driving. So in case you're gonna be driving in Shillong, make sure that you're also carrying a poncho and wearing something warm on you. So aaj mere sath kuch bahut funny hua. I was up and about early in the morning and I wanted to visit this place, and I put it on Google Maps, but unfortunately the maps guided me to the wrong location, and I spent at least an hour and a half just figuring out the route and also trying to get to some place that made sense. But yesterday I was shooting a food video, and in that food video I said that the only cafe I haven't tried out based on your recommendations is ML05, and that is because this cafe is way off the city. But today, while touring Shillong, I finally arrived here, and I'm really excited about having a meal here. Matilang Park, and it's very close to ML05 Cafe. So if you're coming to ML05 Cafe, you can make a quick stop over at this place too, because it's beautiful. So this is actually the Elephant Falls viewpoint, and quite scenic actually. And plus the entire drive till this point was so pretty. Itni sundar drive thi, and plus itna acha weather hai. Maza hi aa gaya matlab. Unbelievable कि शिलोंग के इतने पास एक इतनी प्यारी जगह है. I'm so glad that I made it here, because after today morning I wasn't expecting that I was going to actually make it here, क्योंकि बहुत time लग गया था रास्ते ढूंढने में. This place was fairly easy to find though, and I just followed the maps. And one tip for anybody who's coming to Shillong, make sure that you download offline maps on Google, because offline maps are going to be very helpful, especially in places where you don't have any internet. Okay, so the weather has changed quite quickly. It started raining, and actually it keeps raining for most part of the day, but today I wasn't expecting that it was going to start drizzling. But I found a perfect haven to save myself from the rain, and also in the bargain I'm going to have some puchkas. जेल रोड, और भैया आपका नाम क्या है?
राजनीति कुमार.
राजनीति कुमार, और इनके पुचकार भैया के बहुत ही अच्छे हैं, बल्कि बहुत ही तीखे भी थे, और मुझे बहुत मजा आया खाने में, तो यहाँ पे आके जरूर पुचकार ट्राई करना. Okay, so the landmark to this place is Vishal Mega Mart, and from there, right across the street, you can come to have these heavenly puchkas. Pushka party, I made it all the way to Umiam Lake. It was about 40 minutes from the main city. For me, it took 40 minutes on scooty, and the roads are absolutely fabulous to this place. On a car or on a cab, it may take longer depending on what vehicle you have, but I would honestly recommend anybody to get a scooty, especially if you're young people. But if you're traveling with family, or if you have a bunch of people with you could also rent a cab. And another thing I'd like to mention is that on the way I met a bunch of cyclists who were cycling on this road, and they were apparently going to work. Today I suddenly realized I should have been working in Shillong all my life. Those guys back there, they were on cycles, and the owner of this store is actually cycling to his office today. Can't afford that kind of a luxury in a city, but you can definitely do that while you're in Shillong. Second place that you can come to besides that viewpoint is Orchid Lakeview Resort. This resort is actually based along the lake, Umiam Lake. And it's a really beautiful property. I was initially thinking of coming and staying here, but then I realized that it's going to be way too isolated for a single person. But otherwise, this place is perfect for people who are traveling with family and who are looking for a really pretty resort. Also, it's managed by the government of Meghalaya, so it's quite affordable. I think I'm going to also catch on some buffet lunch over here. They also have a very affordable buffet lunch in case you guys are interested. And if you don't want to live in the property, you can definitely come here and get some lunch. I'm back from Umiam and the lunch there was pretty nice. It was a buffet lunch. But after that lunch, I'm back for some puchkas, and these puchkas are so good that I've come here again all the way from Umiam Lake. So with this we come to an end of this video, and I had the most amazing time here in Shillong. In fact, while I was coming to Meghalaya, I had planned that I was going to cover more places around Meghalaya because I wanted to be covering a greater ground, but eventually I realized that June is not the most perfect time for covering places like Dwaki because the river has to be clear if you really want to be visiting there. So I couldn't visit those places, but Shillong in itself was such a surprise package for me because it's an absolutely beautiful place, an amazing place for just a few days of vacationing, especially if you want to come with your family and you'll have a great time here. But before I end this video, I also have a surprise for you guys. As of today, while I'm shooting this video, we just hit 15,000 subscribers. Now I know that by the time this video goes out to you guys, it's probably going to be a while. But I asked you guys to put me questions with the hashtag sit down video. So I have one such question, and I think I'll be taking these questions at the end of each video for you guys. So I have a question from Divya Nadar here, and she asks me your dream travel destinations / countries. So I think for now my dream destination has to be one of Italy or Philippines. I'm really looking forward to visiting these two countries, and hopefully by the end of this year I may have visited these places. So let's hope that happens soon. But for now, this is the end of the video. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure that you like it and share it with your friends. Leave me a comment down below and let me know which is your favorite segment. And subscribe to my channel. I'll see you next time. Okay guys, bye bye.